ओ गॉड, हेलो। हाय
यस मैम,
एम आई ऑडिबल नाउ?
यस मैम।
ओके, कैन यू सी द शीट? सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द ट्यूटोरियल।
यस मैम।
CO2 एंड CO3 प्रॉब्लम्स व्हिच आर लेबल्ड एज, लेट्स सी, इट इज सॉल्विंग द कैलकुलेटिंग इवैल्यूएटिंग द लाइन इंटीग्रल। सो लाइन इंटीग्रल आई हैव टोल्ड यू डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स। You see one in the Cartesian form. When to work in the Cartesian form, I told you, and when to work in parametric form. When it is given, asked, or it's a circle, it's an ellipse, or it's a helix. Under these circumstances only, the type of the problem you will work, that is, you'll transform the given Cartesian curve to parametric form and then evaluate. When you say curve, it has only one dimension, one parameter. Again, I am repeating, right? And the lastly is with respect to S. So with respect to S, if the line integral is given to you, then you need to transform it to the parametric form and then work out, right? Let's see the first example. Now you one by one are only going to answer me out. The first question, F bar is given to be XY, x square y square. Okay, and the path C is given to be the quarter circle from, I'll sketch it, from 2 0 to 0 2. Okay, they're saying it's a quarter circle, it's not a straight line, something like that. Fine, if it's a quarter circle, what's the equation of this? X square plus y square is equal to 4. यहाँ पे लिख डालो, तो यहाँ पे भी लिख डालो, x square plus y square equal to 4, and the path defined along this curve is from point 2 comma 0 to 0 comma 2. Okay, this is what is given to you. Now you tell me whether this, in order to evaluate the line integral, will you trans work in the Cartesian form or transform to the parametric form? See the data I've written the way. Okay,
पैरामेट्रिक फॉर्म
हाँ, तो पहला पैरामेट्रिक x of t is equal to what and y of t is equal to what? So cos t, एक ही पैरामीटर, इज दिस करेक्ट? सी, व्हाट आर द
टू कॉस्ट
पैरामीटर्स
इट।
यू टेक, यस, वेरी गुड, एंड y इज इक्वल टू 2 sin t, बिकॉज इफ आई टेक cos t एंड sin t, व्हेन आई स्क्वायर एंड ऐड, आई विल नॉट गेट इक्वल टू 4, सो इट शुड बी 2 cos t and 2 sin t. Square it and add, you will surely get equal to 4. That means this substitution is correct. Then what is dx? Dx is equal to minus 2 sin t dt. Dy will be equal to what? 2 cos t. Or make all the things ready first. And what about the t limits? What will be the t limits? See here, that hint I had given you. X is bounded
0 to pi
between,
बाय 2।
यस, ये देख कर भी पता चल जाता है. ओके, सो लेट्स सी, 0 टू पाई बाई 2, टी बाउंडेड बिटवीन 0 टू पाई बाई 2, करेक्ट, गुड. सो इवैल्यूएट द लाइन इंटीग्रल मींस व्हाट? अलोंग द पाथ सी, एफ बार डॉट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ आर बार. इज दिस अ क्लोज्ड पाथ? नो, इट्स एन ओपन कर्व. यू आर ट्रैवर्सिंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट, फाइन. अगर वो लोगों ने बोला था फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस एंड देन दिस एंड देन दिस, देन इट वुड हैव बीन अ क्लोज्ड पाथ. तो ग्रीन्स थ्योरम applicable है in that case, fine. So but here it is only one path from this point to this point, so it's an open curve, no closed symbol here. So this is equal to c. So let's see what is f bar dot derivative of r bar. F1 dx plus f2 dy. First I'll write it, xy f1 dx, f2 is x square y square dy. Now convert everything with respect to the substitutions that you have taken with respect to only one parameter t, t bounded between 0 to pi by 2. X is what? Substitute. X is 2 cos t. X into y it is. So 4 cos t sin t. Dx substitution, write it. Minus 2 sin t dt. Then this is cos square t, square t and dy substitution into 2 cos t dt. And this is within no time you'll get the answer using the reductions. So you are going to give me answers now. Minus 8 cos t sin square t plus 32 cos cube t, and this is sin square t. Check this statement, is it correct? Whole dt. Will tell me the reduction for this? Minus 8 into. Yes, anyone? Sanika? Sanika? Sanika from metallurgy? Sanika from metallurgy? Anyone can respond voluntarily, please. Do not waste your time. Swapnil, metallurgy. Swapnil, metallurgy. Yes, here, someone answer out, please. Jonas.
Hello, ma'am. 1 into 1 upon 3 into 1.
1 into 1 upon 3 into 1.
Plus
yes.
32.
These are not even, so no pi by 2.
No pi by 2.
Plus. Yes.
32 into 2 into 1 upon 5 into 3 into 1.
Yes. Denominator, what do you have?
5 into 3 into 1.
Good.
Numerator? 2 into 1.
Very good. So this you do simplification, you'll get the answer.
640 into 52.
Yes, 8 by 5, 1 actually, it's a correct answer. Okay, the next B part is what? B part is, now I'm not going to show the evaluations. I would like to ask you people ki, what treatment you will give to that problem. This is your F bar given, x, y, the same function it is here, x square, y square, and path C is a straight line. Straight line from 20 to 02. Okay, so what you should do? Path, this is given to be 2, 0 to 0, 2. What to do? Points are given from this point to this point. Yes, so it is good to represent this in here. This is not equal. This is also not equal. So your equation should be y equal to mx plus c cup form mein aana chahiye. How do you get it? Y minus y1 is equal to the slope into x minus x1. Yes, here. So what is that? Are ye to oral question hai na? These are the intercepts. This is your intercept. This is your intercept. What will be the equation of this line? X plus y is equal to 2 na? Isn't it oral? Yeah, so y minus y1 is equal to slope of x minus x1. You find out this. But when you know these intercepts, and this is an oblique line intersecting x-axis and y-axis, the equation has to be x plus y is equal to 2. When y is 0, x is 2. X is 0, y is equal to 2. RIE. Are you getting? So this is, I'll write it in the form x plus y is equal to 2. I'll write it as y equal to 2 minus 6. Yes or no? Are you getting? Say yes or no something.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So dy will be equal to what? Minus dx. So you represent the line integral with respect to x or else y. So I have decided with respect to x because this is to be eliminated. I want it strictly with respect to x. So I'll require x limits. X is bounded between what? Yeah, to dy lije. This is more convenient, 0 to 2. Okay, so I'll take it as 9. Let it be x because I've written y is equal to 2 minus x. I'm substituting. So x is bounded between okay, not 0 to 2, from this point x coordinate to this second, that is point x coordinate, right? So start evaluating the integral. Jo bhi hai aapka is equal to along the path c it is, so it is xy dx. So x into y, I'm representing in terms of x ki limits chal rahi hai. So y is 2 minus x dx as it is, plus x square into y square, 2 minus x whole square. Y substitution, y is 2 minus x. So this is y square, so 2 minus x whole square. And dy substitution means minus dx. Yes, yeah, x bounded between 2 to 0. And solve this. Yes, all of you, you know how to make the things. So evaluate, you'll get the answer. I think the C part, we have done it in the class. The question is already in the parametric form. Yes, yeah, C part. F bar.
Yes, ma'am.
It is x minus y, y minus z, and z minus x. Path C is given to be as in the parametric form. And point, its parameter is t, but t limits are not provided. Logo ne bola, along this curve, but from this point 2, 0, 0 to 2, 2 pi and 0. Okay, what is the parametric representation they have given? 2 cos t, t and 2 sin t. Fine, yeah? See, yeah? I want t limits. So this is not going to give you the limits. This is also not going to give you the limits. But y coordinate is surely going to give the coordinates. Y is bounded between 0 to 2 pi. But what is y here in the curve? It is t bounded between 0 to 2 pi. These are the limits for t. Fine. And then you start with, yes, f bar dot derivative of r bar equal to along the path c. So ye x minus y hai dx, f1 dx. First try this, y minus z dy plus z minus x dz along the path c. Now here x substitution is what substitute y, y substitution, dx substitution. Haan, to ye to reh gaya. So from this I come to know x is equal to 2 cos t, y is equal to t, and z is equal to t, a 2 sin t. So I'll be requiring dx is what, dy is what, dz is equal to what. All the substitutions you do in this, put the t limits and finish it off. Fine, yeah. From this path C given, I've got x, y, and z components. So this I'll substitute here. What about then dx, dy, dz? Differentiate with respect to t. So dx is equal to minus 2 sin t dt. Dy is equal to dt. This will be equal to 2 cos t dt. Do all these substitutions. Your entire single integral will be respect to only one parameter, single parameter, that is t. Put the limits for t and finish it off. Fine, yeah? Exactly the same way d part, this example also we have done it in the class. See the f part. Yes, yeah, this not f part, e part that I'll look into. E part is given to be as f bar is equal to z e to the power xz, second component twice sine hyperbolic 2y, and the third component is e to the power Z. Okay. So F bar is equal to this. And what is it? Path C is given to be as to the, sorry, it is X e to the power X Z. Fine. Thank you. Y equal to x, z equal to x square, and x bounded between, sab kuch de rakha hai, minus 1 to plus 1. F, but the vector function is given in x, y, z. Yes, the components are the functions in x, y, z. the curve is also with respect to x. So you need not think about ki isko parametric form mein karna hai nahi karna hai, sab kuch de rakha hai seedha seedha. And it is simple. It is not, neither a circle, it is neither an ellipse, helix nahi hai, or it is not given in parametric form. So let's begin with that only. Path C is given to be as y equal to x, z equal to x square. So dy will be equal to what? And dz will be equal to what? So this is dx, this is 2x dx. So your integral is going to be with respect to x. And x limits are also given here. So how you will work out? Path C, f bar dot derivative of r bar, z e to the power xz dx plus 2 sine hyperbolic 2y dy plus x into e to the power xz dz along the path C. You cannot write the limits here because this function is a function in entire, it's a function you get each term that is different. This form f1, f2, f3, they are the functions in x, y, z. So you cannot put the limits right now. You will put the limits only when you see that the function is with respect to only one variable. Fine. So this is equal to z substitution. Our function solution has to be with respect to x. Z is what? X square. E to the power x into z. So this will be e to the power x cube dx. No problem as it is. Plus 2 sine hyperbolic 2y. Y is what? X. Dy is what? Dx. X as such, e to the power, this will become x cube. Dz substitution. So it is 2 into x square, it becomes dx. So this is all a function in x now. Entire, all the functions, now you can see. Fine. They are the functions in x. Single variable it has come. Now you can put the limits minus 1 to plus 1. Fine. Now let's check whether they are even or functions, because see the type of the limits given. This is neither even nor odd. You cannot say anything. Because when I replace f of minus, this suppose this is function f of x. So f of minus x, what happens? It is neither f of x, neither minus f of x. Even or kuch nahi. What about this? This is an even function. Kuch nahi bol sakte. These two are similar functions. So if you want for this, you can even odd concept. Nahi to fir chalega. So this is, I'll cut down this. This is 3 times ho gaya. 2 plus 1 becomes 3. Gaya. So I have cancelled this. So evaluate it. Now this is e to the power x cube, and x cube derivative is here. So integration is e to the power fx into f dash means e to the power fx. X cube. What about this? Plus twice, you are integrating, not differentiating. So it is cosine hyperbolic 2x all divided by 2, limits running from minus 1 to plus 1. And simplify, you'll get the answer. Fine. So this is line integrals done. The next, and we have done every type of example. I'll take one example from this, that is, now see this question in the tutorial. This is with respect to the arc length S. Arc length S, fine. And they've already given this form, but exam, this is not the form, this form will not be given. You need to interpret it. You need to recall this part, fine. Because I told you, ye ds with respect to the arc length. So I'll write it as ds by dt into dt. But ds by dt, when I started with the vector calculus, the first point itself I had specified as what is tangent vector. And in that tangent vector, I had, along with that, I had specified magnitude of derivative of r bar. Magnitude of the tangent vector is nothing, but it is the rate of change in the arc length. That is ds by dt. Ye bataya tha aap logon ko wahan pe. So you need to just convert this and then get the parametric representation when you say parameter t. So let's see, I'll take this example. A part, B part, toh logon ne parametric form mein de rakha hai, so you need not worry about that problem. So this is your question number 2. F of r d ds. Are you getting all of you? So this is ds by dt into dt. And this is along the path cc f of r of t now, because we are representing this function r function in r as a function in the parameter t, whereas this is what magnitude of derivative of r bar with respect to. So path c is given to be y equal to 3x. Jo de rakha hai wo pehle likho, from 0 to 2, 6. So you need to see here t hai, parameter t hai, r bar hai. Yes, here. So I'll be requiring the parametric representation of this curve. Bataiye kya hona chahiye? Is it a circle? Is it a helix? Is it an ellipse? Nahi hai isme se. Simple, x is equal to t and y is equal to 3t. There is no third component because you can see the point 0 0 2 6 doi. Yes, here. So it is in two dimension. Fine, yeah? These points, only two components. So I require derivative of r bar with respect to t. I've got this r bar. Now derivative of r bar and then the magnitude. So derivative of r bar with respect to t. So this will be 1 and 3. Magnitude of this is equal to what? Under root of 9 plus 1, and that is equal to root 10. Fine, yeah? And therefore, what can you say? Yes, they've asked you to evaluate this f of r ds. See the form I have stated here with respect to that. T limits kya hone wali hai? Either you take x or y. X bounded between 0 to 2. Y bounded between 0 to 6. Ye points is samajh mein aata observing this. But I want T limits. What is x here? This curve C.
0 to 2.
Yes, it will be 0 to 2. Kuch bhi karke dekh lo, to bhi y is equal to 3t. Bounded between 0 to 6 means what? It is t bounded between 0 to 2. This is how you get it. It should give you the same answer. T limits. Yes, here? F of r. What is f of r given? F de rakha hai aapka equal to x square plus y square. This is given. Here? So x is what? X is what? T square plus y is what? 3t. Okay, block this. Isko block karo. This is very important. So this will be what? This is a function, x square plus y square. So that will be plus 9t square whole square. Then ds substitution, ye magnitude, that is root 10. Evaluate, you will get the answer. Fine, that is how you do it. अब यहाँ पे तो ये parametric form में दे ही रखा है, so there is no question. T limits भी दे रखा है. You should only you need to see that this x will be what? Cos cube t whole square plus x into y. So cos cube into sine cube whole raised to the power 1/3. So that is cos t sine t. T bounded between 0 to 2π. Fine, yeah. But वो ds का क्या करेंगे? So this is r bar, so find out derivative of r bar with respect to, find its magnitude. What's the magnitude of here? D part, r bar is given to be as cos cube sine cube t. Our derivative of r bar with respect to t, so this is minus 3 sine square t. And what about this? Minus 3 no this is correct this is wrong what's the derivative of this yes anyone derivative of this what's the derivative of cos cube t hello
minus 3 cos square t sin
square t into sin t. Good. What about this? 3 sin square t. And then sine derivative is cos t. Magnitude I'll be requiring. So this is under root. So this will be 9 cos to the power 4 t sin square t plus 9 sin raised to the power 4 t cos square t. Yes, here. So this is what you get. What to do? This is equal to under root of 9 cos square t sin square t out common. And in the bracket, you are left with cos square plus sin square, and that is equal to 1. Yes, here. Cos square t plus sin square t, yahan pe bracket mein aayega. I have taken this out common. So this will be equal to 3 cos t sin t. Okay. And now we come to the integral f of r ds along the path c. We have made that f of r bar, not r bar, f of r of t, magnitude of derivative of r bar with respect to t, dt. Now you have to substitute. What is f of r? Check it. This is your f of r given. X cube plus xy whole to the power 1 by 3. Yes, here. See the this r bar given there. X substitution. So this is x square. Yes, it is x square. So this will be cos raised to the power 60. And plus x into y. X into y means product. Whole raised to the power 1 by 3 is cos t sin t. So plus cos t sin t. And this magnitude of got it to be as 3 cos t sin t. Whole dt. T limits are already provided 0 to pi. Yani reduction to banta hai yahan pe. Yes, yeah. So let's see what is that reduction we're going to do here. First, simplify the terms 0 to pi. Seedha aap reduction pe nahi ja sakte hain. That is 3 cos raised to the power 70 sin t plus 3 cos square t sin t. Whole dt. Over the domain 0 to pi, what is the value to this? Over this domain 0 to pi.
Zero.
This is negative, so answer is 0. Nahi to karte baito. What about this? This is a product is positive in this quadrant. Cos being negative, but whole square makes it positive, and the product of two positive functions is positive. So this will become 0 twice of 0 to pi by 2, 3 cos square t sin square t d. Yes, yeah. Once this is done, it's ready for reduction formulas. 4 into 2, 1 into 1. Both are even indices. So it is pi by 2. And that will give you the answer. Have you understood that? Fine. Got it here? Is it the same answer? Check it. 2, 3 is a 6. 3 pi by 8 is the correct answer. Yes, answer given is 3 pi by 8. Fine. Any doubts in question number 3? Check the following integrals for path independence. Check karne ke liye bola hai, reason nahi karne ke liye bola hai. Okay. So check karne ke liye path independent hai yani, so you go for del cross f bar. If it comes out to be 0, then you can say that path independence hai. Because when is it path independence? If it has the potential. And if it has the potential, that means I'll be substituting f bar dot. F bar as del f and cross product of such function vector functions is always 0. Fine here. Have you understood that? How do you find out the curve?
Yes,
You know
ma'am.
it. Fine. So it will be, I'll just show you one. You work it out. J, K, agar ye 0 aa jata hai. What are the components of this? This is a vector quantity with respect to x, partial derivative with respect to y, partial derivative with respect to z. What are the components of f bar c here? This is the first example given. You have f1 dx. F2 dy means minus 2 sin x sin 2y. Yes, yes. So these are the components. Third component hai nahi isme, so it is taken to be as 0. Cos x cos 2y. And this is minus 2 sin x sin 2y. And this is 0. Correct here? This is how you write it. But be careful. F1 dx pehla hona hi chahiye. Agar ulta sulta de rakha hai, to you first write it in the proper form. F1 dx plus F2 dy and then F1, F2, F3. This is how you'll write the components. Work out this. It should come out to be derivative 0 with respect to z 0. Minus sign. Second component 0. 0, so minus 0 ya kuch bhi liko, to it is 0 only. The next, this is with respect to x, what do you get? Yes, minus 2 sin x sin 2y minus the other part. Partial derivative with respect to y is yes. What is the partial derivative with respect to y? Minus cos x twice cos x into sin 2y. Is it 0? Is it 0 here? Are you getting 0, 0, 0, all the components?
Ma'am, that third term first value should be cos 2y. No? Sorry, cos x, cos x.
This is cos x, cos 2y is the function. You're differentiating this third component now. So you're differentiating this partially with respect to x. Oh, yes, correct. Cos x sin 2y. Correct, correct. Yes. And this with respect to y. Ye kya ho raha hai? This minus into minus becomes plus. What is that? Yes, ye ho gaya plus. And so therefore this is also 0. All the three components are 0 and this is equal to 0 vector. So you have got the curl to be 0, so ye path independent ho gaya. Agar give reason bola, so this is not the only reason. You have to state that this domain is so and so functions. The components of the f bar are continuous, having continuous partial derivatives and all that. Reason nahi puchha, don't give. Just check karo and then work out. Now you have checked and you say that yes, it is path independent and therefore you start working for it. How do you work for it? I told you the direct techniques. Some techniques I have told you. How to write this integral? Say yeah. It is cos 2y into cos x dx. This is how I'll write it. Fine. So ye function hai yahan pe. Wahan pe kya function hai? Let's find out. So my first question. This is the derivative of which function? Minus sin x. Okay. I'll write it plus or fine. This is the derivative to which function? Minus sin x. Minus sin x derivative is, check it. No, plus sin x, sorry. Fine. So this is sin x, fine. So ye circle kar dete function. What is the derivative of this function? Minus 2 sin 2y whole of dy. You can check. Do you find the same term here, the second part? It's minus 2 sin x sin 2y dy. Absolutely correct. Why? This is derivative of this function is this and derivative of this function is here. So this is whatever the path is given, you write it, ye points jo kuch bhi hai yahan pe. So this is derivative of sin x into cos 2y. And integration of this will be, this is a definite path is given to you, and therefore no arbitrary constant here. 2y limits jo kuch bhi hai, substitute and get the answer. Yeah, fine. So that is how you'll work for all the CABCT no parts. Any doubts with these line integral problems?
Yes. Ma'am, please explain the last part again, ma'am. At
which part?
This? The same page. Same page. Starting. This. Yes.
Okay, see here. Again, I repeat. See that integral and write the first term as it is. Okay. But write it in the proper form. Just form a diya, it is not the correct form. See here. See this question. This is cos x cos 2y dx. This is in the question. But I need to write this first term properly and then try to identify. Okay. Just pay attention here how I write it. See this. This is cos 2y into cos x dx. Suppose मैंने आगे का टर्म नहीं देखा है, ओके? So I need to identify what and which. These are the two questions. पहला question is which. This is the derivative of which function sin x, ओके? This is the derivative of which function sin x. Sin x का derivative को मिल गया. What is this? What is the derivative of this function? I'll write it here. Okay, this is your function. These two circles. Okay, what's the derivative? Minus 2 sine 2y dy. Now you check. See this first term cos x cos 2y dx. Cos x cos 2y dx, correct. Second term is minus 2 sine x sine 2y dy. So this is absolutely correct, and I can say that it is derivative of which function? See here, is function ka derivative either hai? Is function ka derivative either hai? Which are the two functions? This and this. So it is sin x into cos 2y. This here, what is the derivative to this? The integration of this? So it will be sin x cos 2y. बाकी के सारे क्वेश्चंस अगर वो पाथ इंडिपेंडेंट है, दिस इज हाउ यू कैन ट्राई पुट द राइट द लिमिट्स इवैल्यूएट एंड गेट द आंसर. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड नाउ सर? हेलो.
यस मैम.
फाइन. व्हाट्स योर नेम सर?
साद.
ओके फाइन, लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट नाउ. Try out these. If you do not get, you can ask. Yeah. Now, that was only line integrals. You could see the line integrals that you evaluated, they were not closed paths. So, हम लोगों ने वहाँ पे कुछ सोचा ही नहीं कि वहाँ पे ग्रीन थ्योरम होता है एप्लीकेबल. नहीं, वो ओपन है तो उसको बिल्कुल नहीं अप्लाई होता. Okay. Now, see this. Using Green's theorem, evaluate. You Green's theorem बोल दिया तो you can see that the symbol here, it's a closed curve. That means this curve is closed. This is the closed symbol. Counterclockwise means anti-clockwise around the boundary C of the region R. Where? Now you can see this. This region R. I'll not talk much about the F bar right in the beginning. I'll see. I want to check whether these are closed paths or not. Region is the square with these vertices. Square bol diya to vertices de rakha to it has to be a closed path. But how many that square has how many boundaries? How many curves you will find there? C1 from this to this. This to this is C2. From this point is C3. Or koi to bhul jayega C4. Because closed pura hona chahiye. So from this to this also. Then you say it is closed path. Evaluate the line integrals for all these, along all these paths, and add them. This is what you are going to do. Let's see this. X to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 is equal to 1. Is it required to represent it in the parametric form? Yes, can you represent this in the parametric form? ये क्लोज्ड पाथ है, तो बी केयरफुल, इसका स्केच कर करके देखो कर्व. इट इज समथिंग स्क्वायर विथ ब्लंट एजेस. यस यम दे आर नॉट यू विल नॉट सी द कस्प एट द एजेस ऑफ द स्क्वायर. नो, इट विल बी अ कस्प. फाइन, इट्स नॉट अ नोड. फाइन, वो ऐसा नहीं, ऐसा कस्प मींस फाइन पॉइंट्स. दिस इज ऐसा पॉइंट्स नहीं आता है वो. समथिंग लाइक दिस इट कम्स. Okay, so it is a closed path. So it is centered at origin. Okay, so closed path hai to Green's theorem directly kya hota hai dekho. Sometimes you'll see that what to do using Green's theorem bolen to apply karo, no problem. Let's see for this. This is region is y equal to x square and y is equal to x. These two curve are intersecting and the equality condition states that the region bounded by these two curves. Okay? So that is, again, this is a closed path. Green's theorem applicable hai yahan pe. Yahan pe using theorem likha hai, Green's theorem. So aapko reason dene ki zarurat nahi hai why you are using Green's theorem and all that. Suppose this statement was not there, evaluate. But you know that these are all closed paths. So I need to, or it will be more convenient, instead of evaluating all four line integrals along multiple number of curves of the closed path, finitely many curves of the closed path, ECM. So instead of that, it is better to evaluate the double integral. Okay. So this is region bounded by the square of side 2. Now here it is verbal statement. That is bounded by the square of side 2a determined by the inequality is this. So what it is? X, magnitude of x less than or equal to a means absolute of x less than or equal to a means x is bounded between minus a to plus a. Y is bounded between minus b to plus b. Limits are going to be. Okay, so Green's theorem apply karo, seedha seedha evaluation ho jayega. Let's see. I want to apply the Green's theorem now, how to work with it. Question number 4. Question 4, when you are working with let's see the next problem now. Am I audible? Yes, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is using Green's theorem. So what I'll do is, first thing, I'll state the data. F bar is given, 3y square x minus y to the power 4. Only two components this has, and r is the square vertices. So this is 1 1. No, this is 1 1. Then minus 1 1. Then minus 1 minus 1, and this is 1 1. So these are the vertices of the rectangle. Fine, yeah. You can see this is x axis, y axis, and then I have marked it. This is square. Fine. So C1 path, C2 path, I'll label it. This is C1. इसको ले लेते C1 path. C2 traverse in anti-clockwise, बोला है counterclockwise. This is C2, this is C3, C4. Okay, fine. So C1 path. C1 path is what? From which point to which point? 1 minus 1 to 1 1. Can you tell me what is the equation of this line? ये देखकर ही समझ में आता. What is the equation of this line?
X equals to 1.
वहाँ नहीं समझ में आ रहा है तो यहाँ पे देखो. X is equal to. Whereas 0, 2, 2, 0 जब ऐसे points थे तो वहाँ पे आप ऐसा नहीं लिख सकते. Okay? So you had to find that they were the intercept on X and Y and it was an oblique line. Fine. So X plus Y is equal to 2. सीधे पता चला. But यहाँ पे this is 1, 1. This is minus 1, minus 1. Okay? This will give you the equation of that line. X is equal to 1. Whereas y is bounded between what? Minus 1 to plus 1. Dx is equal to 0. Okay. This y limits will tell you that your integration has to be with respect to y. Y ki limits likhi aapne. So it is integral along the path C1. This path C1 is an open curve. Okay. So no closed symbol here. Though in the Green's theorem, you'll find it is closed. This entire path, when you consider, it is closed. But only C1 open. So it is f bar dot derivative of r bar. So this is C1 f1 dx plus f2 dy. 3y square dx plus x minus y to the power 4 whole dy. Y bounded between minus 1 to 1. Now I'll do all the substitution and see that this function, this integrand is entirely with respect to y. Let's say x, y is what? We want it because ये y का limits है. Dx is what? 0. So this is gone. X is 1 and I'll substitute 1 minus y to the power 4 whole dy and integrate this. You can see the limits are running from minus 1 to plus 1. Try to reduce your work. ये limits is form में जबी भी रहती है, so you should always check whether the function is even or odd. So f of y is equal to 1 minus y to the power 4. What happens? F of minus y, if I take it, will be 1 minus y to the power 4, and that is equal to f of y. So this is even function, and therefore I can say that this is equal to 0 twice of 0 to 1, 1 minus y to the power 4 whole dy. Evaluate and get the answer. So this is y minus y to the power 5 whole divided by 5 twice 0. okay. Just see the second part of the question, the parametric curves. So you have to find out what are the parametric curves of the surface, u constant and v constant. That they had explained you all the things. Agar wo cone hai, suppose it's a cone, to cone ke upar kaise ye slant lines rahega, then if there will be circles or maybe ellipses, how to identify wo kya hai. So that all I have explained. Fine, yeah? And the third part is normal vector. Now नॉर्मल वेक्टर आपने वेक्टर डिफरेंशिएशन में भी किया यूजिंग डेल एफ कंसेप्ट. यस, ये वो कब करो जब आपको एक स्केलर फंक्शन दे रखा है, फंक्शन इन एक्स वाई जेड, तो डेल एफ से करो. ओके, ओनली वो लोगों ने बोला नॉर्मल वेक्टर, इतना ही बोला, एंड द फंक्शन इज गिवन इन एक्स वाई जेड, वो डेल एफ का कंसेप्ट यूज करो. बट इफ इट इज वेक्टर इंटीग्रेशन पार्ट में कैसे रहेगा, सम सरफेस इज गिवन इन एक्स वाई जेड प्लेन एंड दे आर आस्किंग यू टू इवेलुएट द सरफेस इंटीग्रल. Okay, so then you have two choices open, del f ya to phir n bar. Fine, yeah? But if they are asking, they have given you the parametric representation of the surface, so parametric form mein hi normal vector karna hai. Don't go to del f, though it is simple. Ye bhi simple hai, no problem with it. Fine, yeah? So let's see. Three parts this question has. One example I'll take, and then now they have given you as a surface to be as r bar of uv equal to u cos v, u sin v, and u square. Yes, here, this is what they have, this much only they have given. This question has three parts. First, ये क्या surface है in Cartesian form that you need to represent. First, you write it out in this way. What is x component? This. What is y component? U sin v. What is z component? Z equal to u square. Now you can establish a relation between these two, because यहाँ पे z is equal to u square and this is going to give you a function in u only. So x square plus y square equal to u square. And z is equal to u square. Correct here? What is the conclusion? Therefore, surface S is what? X square plus y square. Square, just see. What is u square? Equal to z. So, what is this? This is a paraboloid. But itna likhe nahi chalega. Have they given apart from this anything? No. So, ye, this is the surface of the paraboloid. But what kind of paraboloid it is? You need to write. You need to state the things very clearly. Okay, fine. So this is a paraboloid. Or kya likh sakte hain? Paraboloid of revolution likho ya kuch aur. And axis of symmetry, you can write it. Axis of symmetry is along z axis. Fine. So that is how you'll write it. Paraboloid. And symmetrical along z axis. Height goes along z axis that you need to specify. So first part is done. Okay. Second part kya hai? To identify the parametric curves. Okay. But prior to that, I need to know what is this v? Is it a base angle or ye to paraboloid hai? So is it talking about ye u or v kya? This is your base angle. Angle se refer karta hai. So be careful. Okay. Some people, I have told you all the time ki u ko base angle rakho. When you make your choice, see that you keep, you fix yourself to u as the base angle. Fine. But let it go now here. It is asking for the parametric curves. So u equal to constant and v equal to constant. क्या इम्प्लाई करता है, कैन यू टेल मी? जस्ट सी हियर, आई विल गिव यू द हिंट. u कांस्टेंट यहां पे डालते जाओ, u इक्वल टू 1 2 3 4 5 6, u इक्वल टू 1 2 3 4 5 6 कांस्टेंट वैल्यूज. ओके, व्हाट इज गिविंग, व्हाट इज इट गिविंग यू? सर्कल्स इन द प्लेन z इज इक्वल टू k, वेयर k बिलोंगिंग टू r. Which are positive r or negative r? ये कैसा paraboloid है? ऐसा है. Can z be negative? No. Are you getting? यस और नो? आर प्लस लिखोगे, सो दिस एम्प्लाइज व्हाट? सर्कल्स इन, सो देयर इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर इक्वल टू के स्क्वायर एंड जेड इक्वल टू k square, where k belonging to r plus union 0 भी डाल दो. 0 हो सकता है क्या? Yes, it will. This origin is a part of the surface. Okay, union 0 plus. Are you getting? या तो फिर r plus ही डाल दो, no problem with it. Yes, yeah. अगर ये circles है इसके ऊपर के, so what about these v constant agar kar diya to, now will you identify v constant kar diya to kya ho jayega? If I take v is equal to 0 to ye kya ho jayega? This will be 1, this will be 0, so x is equal to u, z is equal to u square. So what is that giving you? Yes, paraboloid पे और क्या होगा? Circles and what? Parabolas? Which kind of parabolas? Yes, x is equal to, yes, z square. No. Please blur out. What do you get?
Z is equal to x square.
Z is equal to x square. And what? Height is going along z axis. Symmetry. So z is equal to y square. So these are the two parabolic curves you'll find on this surface. Ye is tarah se. Correct here? Fine. So these are the two parabolic curves. V constant. Fine. So parabolas on the surface, fine. The next is B part, third part is finding the normal vector. Normal vector means n bar. They have specified which representation you should take. Diya hai, so wahi lo. Nahi diya hai, normal vector bola hai. And the question is in the parametric form here. You can see question is in the parametric form. So koi bhi representation le lo. Orientation r bar u cross r bar v or r bar v cross r bar u, but specifically they have asked you to do this. So cross product means it's a determinant I j k. Fine, yeah. Partial derivative of r bar with respect to u is what? Then next third row elements will be what? R bar with respect to v. Fine, and evaluate it out. It's a vector, so you'll get the components. Use square bracket only for the vector representation. Fine, yeah. So this is how you go about. Wo dusra wala hai, wo waise hi karo aap. Fine. Now here question number 6. He is asking for the parametric representation. So let's see. Number 1, it is a plane. Question number 6. Fine. Question 6, parametric representation. They have given you the plane as number 1. 3x plus 4y plus 6z और कुछ नहीं बोला है, parametric representation बोला है तो उतना ही करो. 6z is equal to 24. So either you represent this x a function in yz or y a function in zx or something. It is more better you represent z a function in xy. So 24 minus 3x minus 4y whole divided by 1 by 6. Okay. And then you go for the parametric representation. This is a plane. Plane means two dimension. So r bar of uv. So you take x is equal to u, y is equal to v. So z kya ho jayega? See, this is an oblique plane. Oblique plane ke liye no cosine, no sine. Sine cosine kab aata hai? When I say circular cylinder, elliptical cylinder. Yes, yeah. If it's a helicoid, वहाँ पे सब चला जाता है, sine, cosine, hyperbolics and all that. Fine. So let's see. Hyperboloids, you'll get the hyperbolic representations. UV. So this will be substitute here. So So 1 by 6, 24 minus 3u minus 4v. This is how you'll do it. Number 1 is over. Second is elliptical cylinder. Number 2. That is 9x square plus 4y square equal to 36. Okay. So what to do? Ab to ye ellipse dikh raha hai. So represent it first in the correct form. X square by 4 plus y square by 9. Equal to 1. Check it. Is it correct? No, somewhere it is. Correct. Fine. Are you able to read the things?
No, it's a bit blurred.
Again, blur. Wi-Fi connection is a problem going on. Now it's clear. Are you able?
Yes, ma'am.
To see.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Fine. So let's see. So what I should see here, I'll represent this as x by 2 whole square plus y by 3 whole square equal to 1. Okay. So I should substitute this as cos theta, this to be as sine theta, and cos square plus sine square is equal to 1. That is, this is what is the concept. So when I say x by 2 is equal to cos t, curve nahi chal raha, surface chal raha hai. Okay. So r bar of uv, not single parameter, it is okay. Fine. This is not a curve. Be careful. Agar ye curve hota to this is equal to cos t sin t. Therefore x is equal to 2 cos t, y is equal to 3 sin t. Aisa ho jata. No, z component will not arise there. Fine, yeah, but this is surface, it is in UV plane. So what to do? The same, it will be 2 cos u. You keep it as the base angle. Kya hai to v lays up the base angle, no problem with it. 3 sin u. So v kaan chala gaya? So height of that elliptical cylinder. So this is your base angle u and this will be your v. Okay. So z is v. Okay. Square and add. Okay. And check. Do you get back this equation or no? When I say x is equal to 2 cos u, x by 2 is equal to cos u. Y by 3 is equal to sin u. Square and we get this equation the same and check. Yes, it gives you, and therefore this is the correct representation, parametric representation. Is that clear, all of you? Now suppose if I say it is 9x square plus 4y square equal to z. Agar ye aisa hota to, or z square if I say. Can you tell me what will be the parametric representation here? Anyone? Please, z square equal to 9x square plus 4y square. Yes, am I audible?
Ma'am, it's buffering a lot.
Yes, Wi-Fi is getting blocked. That's why it's happening. Can you see this now?
Ma'am, this of course.
Bolo.
Cos u by 3, sin u by 2 and v.
See ya. No, see ya. I want this. Fine. So what I should substitute? E. This is z square. I'll write it as 3x whole square plus 2y whole square. Okay, this is the way I'll write it. Now you tell me what I should write. V. So what I should substitute x component to be as 3x is equal to v cos. So x component will be what? C here. So that will be v by 3 cos u. V by 3, no, this is not v by 3, this is v by 2 sine u. So z will be what? Let's check. I'll square this and add. So what do I get? So this will give me, see here, how to check it. This is x component, x is equal to v by 3 cos u. So transfer this 3 to the other side. So this is 3x is equal to v cos u. You'll get 2y is equal to v sine u. Square and add. What do you get? 9x square plus 4y square equal to v square. I want z square. So v ki jagah z aana chahiye. Z component will be v. Have you understood this? So this is how you will make a choice. Now substitute v is equal to, because here you have taken, so this equation and this equation, they are equal, so this parametric representation is absolutely correct. Of the surfaces, the next. Using Green's theorem, find the area of the region under one arch of cycloid.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, tomorrow if we need to write some vector in an answer, then we don't have that bar symbol. Then can you tell a few ways how we can write the answer?
Is tarah se likh sakte ho. How you write, do the typing on mobile? If you want to ask me a doubt, madam, so how do you write vector r?
Even if we type on laptop, still to get those special symbols takes time. So
r cap bar, something like that, you type it. Kisi par aisa question arise nahi hoga aapka zyadatar. So you can just write it vector r or else r cap bar, jo kuch bhi dalna hai, fine. But this such questions won't arise. But representation of the vector, use square brackets only. IJK ka form mein likhoge to wo cap chahiye wahan pe. And LaTeX commands you, people do not know. Yes? So please be careful. Fine? Should we continue? Yes, all of you? Yes, Vardhan? Should we continue? Okay, the next question is, using Green's theorem, find the area of the region under one arch of a cycloid.
Seventh question is remaining. Seventh and eighth.
Which? Seventh and. Oh, I click on that. Back to back. Sorry. Okay. Seventh question is what? Evaluate the surface integral f bar dot n cap, this form. Sometimes they write ds or da, no problem with it. Okay, this is your surface S, and indicate the kind of surface in A and B. So f bar in the first part is given, A part, this is 3x square y square and 0. Where the surface S is what? Given in the parametric form. A parametric form mein diya hai, to parametric mein hi karo. Why do you want it to be in the Cartesian form? Yes, here 2u plus 3v. Where the limits are also provided, u bounded between 0 to 2, v bounded between minus 1 to plus 1. Fine, yeah. When you start with this surface, kya de rakha hai, wo pehle likho and block it. This always I say, whether you are offline or online. बिकॉज वहां पे तो आंसर्स ही लिखने हैं, बट आंसर्स के लिए भी हमको करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स पे जाना है. सो इन दैट केस ब्लॉक दिस, दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट आर बार. देन द नेक्स्ट थिंग दैट यू नीड टू वर्क इज एन बार. दिस इज फॉर दिस फॉर्मूला यू ओनली यूज when you're working with the coordinate planes, surfaces in the coordinate planes, you see, or the sections of the coordinate planes, or lines going, the surface is going parallel to the coordinate, then only, tab tak nahi ye formula. Parametric representation, ye question hi parametric representation mein hai, to parametric representation hi will have to work out. R bar u cross r bar v. Again here there's a choice for you, whether you take this orientation or r bar v cross r bar u. The choice is left to you. This is IJK. Determinant, cross product means this is r bar with respect to u. So 1 0 2 0 1 3, evaluate this. Sorry, this will give you the first component will be what, minus 2, third component minus times of, let's see, 3 minus 0, so this is minus 3, and the third component, that component comes out to be as 1. This is n bar. F bar kya de rakha hai, usko r bar of u v ke form mein convert karo in terms of u and v. So they have given you f bar to be this. So this is x is u, substitute here, y is v, substitute y here. Ye to zero hai, sawal hi nahi uthta hai. So 3 u square and v square, third component is zero, isko block karo. Fine ya? Once this is done, you come to surface integral. No, region R, because now you are entirely switched over. This entire double integral means you have come to the, you trans switched over to UV plane, means it is the region R, not the surfaces now. Okay, so dot product of these two vectors, F bar dot N bar, what is it? It's going to be a scalar. So this is minus 6 U square minus 3 V square whole of DU DV. UV ki to limits de rakhi hain, so U ki kya hai, first write like this so that your substitutions come out to be correct. U limits are what, 0 to 2 and V bounded between minus 1 to plus 1. This is
ma'am, but we haven't take n cap, we have taken n bar. So
why? Because this is, that is what I told you, this formula only for coordinate planes. Suppose S is your coordinate plane, then x equal to 0, y equal to 0, z equal to 0, or else if I say x square plus y square is equal to 1, or else x square plus y square is equal to 1 in the plane z equal to 0, yani ye tabhi apply hoga, some region in the coordinate plane. Or else if I say z is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, x is equal to 2. These are the surfaces going parallel to the coordinate plane. Listen carefully what I am saying. Agar ye coordinate plane ho gaya, x, y. Ye coordinate plane ho gaya, ye coordinate plane ho gaya. But if I say there's a region, this is the region in x, y plane. Okay? Coordinate plane hai na? So that means this formula. If I say no, it is this plane in the, going parallel to the coordinate plane. So ye formula. Got it here? But if it is circle, right circular cylinder, curved surface of that cylinder. Now if I take this cylinder, ye curved surface hai, ye parametric mein jayega. But this surface is in which plane? Coordinate plane mein. So isko ye wala formula. Ye sab pehla lecture surface integral ke waqt bataya hai. Ye surface kya hai? It is going parallel to this coordinate plane, so this formula only. But for this, it is the formula this, f bar dot n bar pu dv. Got it here? Have you understood?
Yes,
these two forms are equivalent. This is for when to use this, that I have told you, and when to use this. Abhi ye to question hi parametric form hai, to udhar kyun jana hai? This is f bar, here is a function in xyz. This component may be a function in xyz or may be a numerical constant. Kuch to ho sakta hai, kuch to hoga wo. Da kya hoga? Unit vector hai, to ye unit unit normal vector hai. Yes, here. So uske components accordingly honge na? Fine. So be careful about it. ये parametric form है, तो ये formula ऐसे ही जाएगा. F bar dot double integral F bar of R bar of UV dot n bar of r bar of uv du dv. Okay, now you solve this limit straightforward. They rakha only you need to be careful. Ye u hai to u ka limit kya hona chahiye. Ye outer limits are for v because du dv outer is you are integrating with respect to v. So outer limits will be for v. Evaluate this and finish it. Okay, so that is how you work. V part is also the parametric representation diya hua hai, limits diya hua hai, sab kuch diya hai. Okay, so in that case you need not bother about ki kaun sa formula use karein. Seedha seedha parametric form hi use karna padega. Okay, sab kuch diya hua hai, limits wagaire sab diya hua hai. The next, in this question one more thing they have asked, ki ye surface indicate the kind of the surface. So what is the kind of the surface here? X is equal to u, y is equal to v, and z is equal to 2u plus 3v. This is what we have, but surface S is what? Therefore surface S will be x yahan pe dalo, y is y ka value, v is what? Substitute here. So what do you get? Z is equal to 2u, u is what? X plus 3v, v is what? Y. So this is your surface, but this is incomplete answer. Yes, here they have given u bounded between 0 to 2. What is u? X. So x bounded between 0 to 2. What about v? It is given to be bounded between minus 1 to plus 1. But y, v is what? Y. So y bounded between minus 1 to plus 1. This is your type of the surface. Got it here? This is what is the answer to the second part. Similarly, the B part also parametric form mein hi solve karo. Pehle surface S kya hai? R bar of UV de rakha hai. Write that and block it. Jo kuch bhi diya hai. Aapko dhunne ke liye nahi bola. U limits are given. V limits are also given. Minus 4 to plus 4. And V bounded between 0 to 5. This is what they have given. Correct here, and f bar also they have given to find out what is n bar. So any order of orientation you can take. Partial derivative r bar with respect to u, that is r bar with respect to v, you will find out. It's a determinant, solve, get the components. N bar is equal to what are they? Find out all three components. Then f bar, f bar in parametric form. So see this, what is here? F bar yahan pe kya de rakha hai? First component F bar they have given you to be as sine yz, first component. Second component is 0 and the third component
sine
is yz. Sine hyperbolic yz it is. Okay, and they have given you for this cos v sine v. This is the parametric sine yz. So this will be what? Sine hyperbolic y into z. So it is cos v sine v. Second component is 0, you can see here, of f bar. Third component is y to the power 4. Y is this, so cos to the power 4 v. Correct here, y is cos v, substitute here. This is f bar. So fir shuru ho jao. सरफेस इंटीग्रल ये पूछा था आपको, पर पैरामेट्रिक फॉर्म में है. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? डबल इंटीग्रल एफ बार ऑफ आर बार ऑफ यू वी डॉट एन बार ऑफ आर बार ऑफ यू वी डी यू डी वी और रीजन आर. रीजन आर इज हियर. ये लिमिट्स दे रखी है, ये लिमिट्स डालो, ये डॉट प्रोडक्ट लो एंड सिंप्लीफाई द इंटीग्रल. डबल इंटीग्रल, आर यू गेटिंग? Yes, here.
Ma'am.
C part I'll come. हाँ बोलिए.
Okay, ma'am. You are on the C part. I had a doubt in the D part.
You have a doubt. Okay, I'll come to it. Yes. शायद वहाँ पे answer wrong आ रहा है कुछ तो. Have you worked out that example?
No, ma'am. I wasn't able to figure out what should be the limits, like, because it's a triangular surface, right? For an oblique plane.
Yes. Okay, that
like
I'll
what
tell
should
you.
be the
This
limits
was
for that
kind of
section?
example I've explained in the class also. Anyway, I'll re-repeat it. C part. Here, f bar is given to be as ax, by, z. Okay, and s is entire surface of this sphere. X square plus y square plus z square equal to d square. ये पूरा आंसर दे रखा है. जैसे एंटायर सरफेस ऑफ द नाउ स्फीयर एंड दे हैव सेड सो इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर टू रिप्रेजेंट इट इन द पैरामेट्रिक फॉर्म यूवी सरफेस ऑफ द स्फीयर वॉल्यूम नहीं. व्हेनेवर आई सी अ स्फीयर इट हैज थ्री पैरामीटर्स रो थीटा एंड फाई. ओके बट व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग दैट विल जनरेट द वॉल्यूम. There all three parameters means you are take considering the volume, but when it's a surface, so it is only the angles that will vary. That is vertical angle and the base angle, theta and phi. But यहाँ पे theta and phi नहीं हम use कर रहे for the surfaces. We are using u and v. So you stick to u. Let it be the base angle, and theta be the sorry theta sorry u be the base angle and v be the vertical angle. R bar of uv. Okay. What is the parametric representation? Rho is constant here. X square plus y square plus z square is equal to rho square. So rho is d here. So d rho is constant d. Cos u the base angle. Sorry, base angle. I'll write the sine v into cos u. T sine v sine u. And what is z? It will be a d cos v. Theta and phi में भी करोगे तो भी चलेगा for this sphere, no problem. But it is better uv की आदत डालो. Fine. When you're working for the surfaces s, not v. Okay. So let's see. R n bar क्या हो जाएगा इसका निकालो. R bar u cross r bar v. Then once you solve this determinant, you will get the vector there. Okay, be careful about the middle component minus times of whatever you get. Agar wo negative aata to ye plus ho jayega. If this is positive value, this will remain to be negative. Once you finish with this f bar, this is your n bar here. F bar is what? Ax, by and cz. Okay, so ax, so this is your x, so ad sin v cos u. By b, so that is b into y. Y is this component, so bd sine v sine u. And now cz, z is d cos v, so cd cos v. Block this, okay, and then you come to double integral. They have asked to evaluate this dot n cap da, but you are working with the parametric representation. So this is over the region R, f bar dot n bar. There's a difference between this and this. Be careful. This is in the Cartesian. This is in the parametric form du dv. ये dot product ले लो. U v का limits क्या हो जाएगा? U is what? The base angle. R cos theta. R sine theta. So u is the base angle. So it's a full sphere with the base angle. So what are the limits for u? Z equal to 0 to 2 pi. What about v? V is the vertical angle. Okay. V is equal to 0 to pi. Fine, yeah. And evaluate this. Are you getting? Yes, all of you. Yes,
yes
or no? Fine. Now you had a problem with the D part, no? Let's see.
Yes, ma'am.
Now they say that it's a triangular surface and its vertices they have given. Fine, yeah? So, how does it look like vertices? Mark it. This is 2 2 0 0. This figure is not required. This is for your application. That is understanding. This intercept is 0 0 4. Fine, yeah? So this surface ABC, this surface, this triangular surface he is talking about, और आपको इक्वेशन तो पता होनी चाहिए इसकी कैसे जाएगी, x अपॉन द इंटरसेप्ट बिकॉज अदर टू आर जीरो प्लस y बाय टू, y इंटरसेप्ट इज टू प्लस z बाय फोर इक्वल टू वन. सो दिस इज टू एक्स प्लस टू वाई प्लस जेड इक्वल टू फोर. दिस इज योर इक्वेशन ऑफ द सर्फेस. फाइन या क्लियर? Now this is not a section of the coordinate plane, neither the surface is going parallel to any of the coordinate planes, you see. So no f bar dot n cap, it has to be the parametric representation. So first let's write what is that surface. 2x plus 2y plus z equal to 4. So it is always good, you should represent z a function in x, y. 4 minus 2x minus 2y, correct here. Once this is done, then the parametric representation r bar of u. This is cos sine, no, why, ye to linear hai to cos sine ka to sawal hi nahi uthta hai. X is equal to u, y is equal to v, so z will be what, 4 minus 2u minus 2v, correct. Find out n bar, r bar u cross r bar v. So what do you get? I j k 1, 0, minus 2, 0, 1, minus 2. Correct here? Yes, is it correct? Check it.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what are the components of the normal vector? 2, minus times of minus 2. So, this becomes plus 2. Third component. One. So these are the components of n bar. Fine, yeah. What is f bar? F bar they have given in Cartesian form. So how do you write? First component is x. So isko block karo, idhar udhar dhyan nahi jana chahiye. So x is equal to u. Second component is minus zx. This into this. No, z into x. Zx minus zx. So that is minus u. It will be.
Z square minus zx.
Oh yes, sorry, z square minus zx. So z square so I can write z square minus zx as what? Z of z minus x. Okay, so I'll write it in this form so that integrations it becomes simple. So this is z is 4 minus 2u minus 2v, and z minus x means what? This is z minus x. So this is 4 minus 3u minus 2v. Correct here? So this is z square minus zx. This will be convenient for me when I'll be integrating. Fine, yeah? And the last component is minus xy. X into y. See here? This is x component, y component. So minus uv. Fine, yeah? So block this. Question arises for the limits now. Okay, see here, what do you have taken? X is equal to u, y is equal to v. Okay, now here one more condition is there. You can see this is bounded by x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0, z greater than or equal to 0. Yes, here, you can see this figure. Fine. Now, x is u, y is equal to v means you are supposed to see the projection of this in xy plane. So, ye x u lene ki bajaye, aapne ye u liya hota, ye v liya hota. So you'll see the projection in yz plane. Okay, but here x is equal to u, y is equal to v, therefore you'll see the projection in u, that is xy plane. X is equal to u, y is equal to v. This is origin. Okay, so xy plane, what do you see? Z is 0. You are taking the projection in xy plane. Z equal to 0 yahan pe dalo. So what do you get? X plus y is equal to 2. So x is u plus y is v equal to 2. This point is 2 comma 0. This is 0 comma 2. Strip sliding along u axis, yeah, v axis. You check it accordingly and take it the limits. Fine, yeah. So when you are integrating this, whatever f bar dot n cap is equal to the region R, f bar dot n bar du dv. And when you are writing the limits, yes, here, now see this du dv, when you say So inner limits for u and outer limits for v. So v is, the strip is sliding along v axis. So v is bounded between 0 to 2 and u is 0 and to this, the edges of the strip. U is equal to 0 and 2 minus v. Correct here from this figure. F bar dot n cap. So this will be what? Scalar function 2u plus twice of, fine. I'll make this convenient for me. I'll take out 2 from this, 2 from this. So what do I get? No, not from this entirely. Not right now. Let's see. Twice of, I'll write this conveniently, 4 minus 2v minus 2u. And I'll put a veniculum here. It's a kind of the bracket. ये दो टर्म्स मुझे साथ में चाहिए एंड 4 माइनस 2 वी माइनस 3 यू ओके करेक्ट सो दिस इज डन थर्ड कंपोनेंट सिंपलीफाई एफ बार डॉट एन बार सो व्हाट डू यू गेट माइनस यू वी होल ऑफ डी यू डी वी एंड यू कीप ऑन इंटीग्रेटिंग इंटीग्रेट दिस यू विल गेट द आंसर हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So that is about evaluation over the surfaces which they have asked. Parametric representation may hi tha. But suppose if I give you a problem like this, evaluate the surface integral over this surface. Z is equal to 1 and x square plus y square equal to 4 and z is equal to 0 aisa kuch to de diya sorry less than or equal to 4 and z greater than or equal to 0 something like this I have given can you tell me over which surface you are to evaluate you are supposed to evaluate the surface integral which surface yes For the surface z is equal to 1 y because equal to 1 or yahan pe aapka z equal to 1 means this is a surface going parallel to the coordinate plane to formula yahan pe jo use hoga f bar dot n cap z equal to 1 what is f bar find out if I say f bar is equal to x y y square and z x something like this I have written So what it will be, f bar will be in the plane z equal to 1 kya ho jayega, x, y, y square and z equal to 1 you substitute here, the third component is x. Whatever the n cap, z equal to 1, aisa upar ka surface hai, this is the surface, the outward normal going parallel to which axis, z axis. So it will be positive k cap, dA will be what? Z equal to 1 is the surface going parallel to the xy plane. So dA is equal to dx dy. Dot product law. dA substitute karo and get the limits. Now in z equal to 1, what do you find? Plane. It's a cylinder. So it will be x square plus y square equal to 4 aega. Here. And x square plus y square equal to 4 is a circular. So r theta may solve karo ye. Here. X is equal to r cos theta because this is a double integral. All these things you are supposed to do. Fine. Have you understood all of you? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So, and there is one question, 19th question. Just see. All of you see that 19th question, 18th and 19th. Nineteenth question is find the surface area. There are two techniques to find. I have given you the formulas. I'll post the notes in the evening. You just go through it. Okay. Area is equal to double integral over the surface area under root of 1 plus fx whole square partial derivative of f with respect to y whole square and whole sorry. Integration with respect to you can see partial derivative with respect to x and y it is so dx dy ho jayega yes here where z is a function in z is a function in xy, tab ye hoga. Okay, see that the question number 19 now. Yes, here they have given you the surface as x plus 2y plus 2z is equal to 12. And cut off by the planes x equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, and y is equal to 1. This is what they have given you. Okay, this is what they have given you. So what to do if I want to use this? I should see that it is represented x a function in yz, or y a function in xz, or z a function in xy. See these limits, that will help you. I need a function in x and y, so I should say z a function in xy. So therefore z is equal to half 12 minus x minus 2y. Okay, and therefore area will be equal to what? Double integral x or y ki to limits de rakhi hai aapko, under root of 1 plus partial derivative of z with, here function is what, z whole square, plus partial derivative of z with respect to y whole square dx dy. And for the surfaces, write it now. X bounded between 0 to 1, y bounded between 0 to 1, straightforwardly there. 1 plus partial derivative of z with respect to x is minus 1 by 2, and whole square is 1 by 4, plus partial derivative of z with respect to y is what? Minus 2, whole divided by 2 is minus 1, so minus 1 whole square is 1, dx dy. Solve this. The answer comes out to be as 3 by 2. Solve it.
Okay. Ma'am, there is one topic, surface integral in without oriental surface. Is that there in syllabus?
Non-orientable surfaces, it's not there in this. See the lesson plan. Non-orientable surfaces are not the part of the syllabus.
Ma'am, because there was a moment of inertia and all that, so I thought.
Hey. Whatever it is, all the application problems also on orientable surfaces only, smooth orientable surfaces. Okay.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. And see the 18th question. They've asked you to evaluate the flux, and they have given across the surface y square equal to 8x. First octant means x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0, z greater than or equal to 0. Bounded by the planes y equal to 4 and z equal to 6. So that means y is bounded between 0 to 4 and z is bounded between 0 to 6. This is what it means. Across this surface he is talking. So is this a circle? Is this a circle? No. So no cos, no sign. Is it an ellipse? No. No cos, sign, no sign. That is it a helicoid? No. So no sine cosine terms. So be careful. So ye kya ho jayega iska? Since this is a curved surface, so parametric representation to hona chahiye. So I'll take y equal to u ya x is equal to u. If I take x is equal to u, so then y will be under root something nahi chahiye aisa value. So what I'll do is y is equal to u I'll take. So x will be what? U square upon 8. Correct here? Yes, here. Don't take as x is equal to u. Agar ye y square is equal to 8u ho gaya, so y is equal to under root of 8u. Which God has asked. I do not know the integration of this. I do not want to do it. I feel more simple if there are no roots. So what I'll do, instead of taking x is equal to u, I'll take y is equal to u. I have written y equal to u here. Therefore, x component will be what? X is equal to y square by 8. Y is u, so u square by 8. So v kya hai? Z is equal to v. Got it here? So n bar nikale. This is your surface S. Now x is bounded between 0 to 4. Nice. X is nahi. Y is bounded between 0 to 4. What is y? What is y? U. So you will get. This is u. So u bounded between 0 to 4. The next z is v. Z is bounded between 0 to 6. So what will be the limits for z? Z bounded between 0 to 6 means z equal to v, so v limits will be 0 to 6, and solve it out. Parametric representation hoga, because this is a curved surface, but not in terms of cos and sine, because if I write u cos u sin u, to ye generate hona chahiye na, aisa parabola. Parabolic curves, they are not the circle, it's not a circular curve. Yes, here, this is not of the form x square plus y square, so be careful. So any other doubt you people have? Any other doubt, so that we can stop off? All these examples, please work out.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, bolie, sir.
मैम आज के आप नोट्स शेयर कर सकते हैं क्या पीडीएफ में, क्योंकि ये ब्लर दिखाई दे रहा था बहुत। हाँ
आज के नोट्स वीडियो है ना सर,
मैम वीडियो में भी ब्लर दिखाई, आज शायद वीडियो में भी ब्लर दिखाई देगा क्योंकि आपको रेंज का प्रॉब्लम था।
ओके ये तो बहुत अनटाइडली है, डाउट Yes, I'll just check the video. If it is not blur, I'll share it on WhatsApp. Okay. Okay, then I'll post it. Okay.
Okay.
Any other doubt in the tutorial?
Ma'am, can you please solve that again? Question fourth question A problem, because I am getting some different answer by using Green's theorem only.
In Green's. Why you are getting different answer?
I am getting minus 2 and like that. So, can you please?
Let's see. Either ho jayega, region limits will be that line integral f bar dot derivative of r bar along the path c. So region f2 with respect to x, you got it to be as 1, and f1 with respect to y, you got it to be as minus 6y dx dy. Now x limits and y limits, now it's a square, na? So x limits and y limits, yes, here. So whatever you want, x is equal to minus 1 to plus 1 and y bounded between minus 1 to plus 1, 1 minus 6y whole of dx dy. Now with respect to x, when you are integrating, this function is constant, yes or no? Are you getting this entire? Yes, will be a, so that's why, how do I integrate? A constant function means what? This is an even function. Constant function is always an even function. Why? Because why did I say this? Here the limits are running from minus 1 to 1. Okay. So I can write it as twice of 0 to 1, 1 minus 6y whole of dx. Limits simple ho jata hai. Or else blunders surely will come at minus 1 to plus 1. Constant function with respect to x, so 1 minus 6y, x limits running from 0 to 1, whole of dy. So this is 1 only, so this is twice of minus 1 to 1, with the limits you get 1 minus 6y only. Again, this is a constant function with respect to y. So is it a constant function? No. This is only constant. What happens if I replace? If I say f of y is equal to minus 6y, 1 minus 6y, or else I'll take only minus 6y. 1 is a constant function, so that is even. F of minus y will, what will it happen? Plus 6y will get, right? Yes, here, are you getting? So this is minus times of minus 6. So this is odd function. Value to this term becomes over this domain, if ye 1 baj jata hai, so that is twice of 0 to 1 dy, ye twice into 2, minus 1 to 1 ka twice of 0 to 1 dy, this is 4 answer then, correct answer.
Okay, I'm got it.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
Fine, we stop with this and work out. If you have any doubts, you can ask on WhatsApp. Boliye, madam.
Ma'am, could you please explain when to take that inward and outward normal.
कहाँ पे inward and outward? Surface integrals पे?
Yes.
See, inward outward normal. When do you talk about? अभी वो अच्छा वो n cap का आप बोल रहे हो?
Yes, ma'am.
तो डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम के लिए कभी भी आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल ओनली वर्क. सपोज दिस इज अ मोबाइल ईयर, दिस इज द अबाउट सरफेस और ये नीचे बेस है इसका. ओके, देयर इज अ बेस ईयर, दिस इज द टॉप सरफेस, दिस इज गोइंग, दिस इज योर जेड एक्सिस. ओके, ऊपर की तरफ ऐसे जेड एक्सिस जा रहा है. तो इफ आई से दिस इज योर जेड इक्वल टू वन प्लेन, तो योर नॉर्मल इज गोइंग पैरेलल टू z-axis, positive z-axis, तो positive क्या होगा? Suppose if I say z equal to zero, ये z equal to zero plane है, so your normal will go in downward direction. Inward normal कहीं नहीं बोला है वो, okay? You'll be working all throughout with outward normals only. तो ये नीचे की तरफ जा रहा है, but it's going parallel to negative z-axis, तो minus k क्या होगा? Now see this edge. If I say this is your positive y-axis, positive y-axis, if I say this, you see, if this is positive y-axis, this surface, if I'm seeing, observing, this surface outward normal in this direction, it is going parallel to positive y-axis, so kya ho jayega? See these figures. अगर ये z equal to one surface है, कुछ तो it is bounded by this line and this line. Okay, this surface है यहाँ पे कुछ तो, उसकी वजह से ये lines आ गए. Okay, so z equal to one is this surface. So इसका outward normal ये z equal to z axis है. So outward normal will go in this direction, but it is going parallel to z axis. इसके positive k है. If I take a surface in xy plane, means equation of this is z equal to 0. So outward normal to this will go in the opposite direction. Parallel to, but parallel to negative z axis. So this is minus k. Okay. Suppose if I say the other figures, if I take a figure like this. X, y and z. If I take a surface here. This is your y equal to 1. Point it is, okay? Y equal to 1 is this line, okay? And this is the plane y equal to 1. Iska outward normal bahar, ye bahar ja raha hai direction. Outward normal is this. But it's going parallel to positive y axis. So, j component. But if I take the surface to this side, suppose. In exit plane. What's the equation of this? Y equal to 1. Sorry, 0. So, iska outward normal is taraf ho jayega. Negative y axis ki direction. And this is minus j. Okay. But if I take this figure. That is, this is x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. If I take, this is x is equal to 1 point, x is equal to 1 line. So if I take this surface, ye samne hai ye surface. Okay, so this is your surface, x is equal to 1, ye shaded jo hai. So x equal to 1. If I take the outward normal, it will go parallel to positive x-axis. Positive x-axis means what? Positive I cap. And if I take x equal to 0, x, y, z, x equal to 0 means this surface. Outward normal us taraf niklega, ye andar aa raha hai. Okay, outward normal means in this direction parallel to negative x minus I cap. Is that clear? This is how it will. Have you understood this now, madam?
Yes, got it.
Okay. एक याद रखो, डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम में व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग विद द नॉर्मल्स टू द कोऑर्डिनेट प्लेन्स ओके एन कैप coordinate planes means x equal to 0, y equal to 0, z is equal to 0. Outward normal will be negative always. Yes, here. अगर मैंने वो सर्कुलर रीजन इन कोऑर्डिनेट प्लेन्स ले लिया तो भी उसका आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल नेगेटिव होगा. क्लियर? इफ आई टेक दिस इन द प्लेन एक्स वाई प्लेन, ये एक्स वाई प्लेन में सर्कल है ना, कोऑर्डिनेट प्लेन में सर्कल है, तो इसका मतलब नहीं हमको यूवी में जाना है, बट दिस इज अ सेक्शन इन द कोऑर्डिनेट प्लेन. तो इसका आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल ओरली यू कैन टेल, एंड दैट इज in the downward direction going parallel to positive negative z axis to minus k cap ho jayega. Suppose yahan pe ye circle hai, so ye to in the coordinate plane hai na, kuch to coordinate plane hoga wahan pe hai wo. So this will be what, positive k cap. This is how you will interpret. Got it or no?
Oh yes, thank you.
Okay. पर ये सरफेस जो होगा ना इसका, इस सरफेस को आप नहीं रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते. इसका नॉर्मल कैप एन कैप क्या है डायरेक्टली नहीं बता, हैव टू वर्क ओवर इट. फाइन, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड?
यस मैम.
ओके फाइन, सो इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन पोस्ट इट ऑन द ग्रुप.
हेलो मैम.
हाँ बोलिए सर.
Ma'am, if the cylinder completely lies in the downward octant, means it will start from z is equal to 0 and go in negative direction, then the outward normal for surface z is equal to 0 will be about which axis, is positive or negative?
Okay. So show the sketch. Yes, sir. आप जो बोल रहे हैं, ऐसा cylinder बोल रहे हो ना? ऐसे?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. हाँ. So that is a very good question that you have asked. Okay. इस तरह का सिलेंडर बोल रहे हो ना आप?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Correct. अब ये देखो यहाँ पे ऊपर का सरफेस हो गया और ये नीचे का सरफेस है, तो इसका आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल कैसे जाएगा? ऊपर की तरफ जाएगा. इसका आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल नीचे की तरफ. If this is x, y and this is z, so this will be positive k cap and this will be negative k. And why positive negative k cap I'm writing? Because these surfaces are parallel to the coordinate plane, xy plane. This surface is a section of the coordinate plane, isliye f bar dot n cap ka. But iske liye no f bar dot n cap. Fine, iske liye f bar dot n bar wala parametric representation chahiye for this. Yes, have you understood? Got it?
Yes ma'am.
Wo ds ko matlab convert kaise karna, matlab wo question number 22 ka jo us 23 ka jo ya 22 b aur 23 ka c hai, to us ds ko sade form mein kaise convert karu?
Acha, okay. Yes, good question. Now this is double integral. Okay, ये parametric representation दे रखा है ना, so ds is as good as da only, so you need not bother about it. Okay.
मैम आप solve करके दिखाओ ना हम please.
Okay, fine. S parametric representation दे रखा है, u cos v, sin v, and 2u दे रखा है. लिमिट्स भी दे रखा है तो टेंशन ही नहीं. यू बाउंडेड बिटवीन 0 टू 1 एंड वी इज बाउंडेड बिटवीन माइनस पाई टू पाई. ओके, सो हियर दिस इज द फंक्शन एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई जेड डी एस लिख रखा है. एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई जेड डी एस, इसका मतलब है दिस आई एम गोइंग टू कन्वर्ट एवरीथिंग इन द पैरामेट्रिक फॉर्म. फाइन, या सो यू नीड नॉट बॉदर अबाउट इट. इसका क्या करोगे
मैम?
बोलिए सर.
मैम एक मैम, आई डोंट गेट इट, व्हाट डिड यू से?
सी हियर, दिस इज ऑलरेडी द पैरामेट्रिक ये क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ है
मैम. क्वेश्चन नंबर 23 के सी में तो नहीं दिया है.
क्वेश्चन नंबर 23 सी यू आर आस्किंग? I thought it is DS बोला ना आपने, so I came to X problem. ओके 20
मैम वो सारा ही प्रॉब्लम डीएस है ना, ऊपर के भी 21 22 में भी है, तो आपने एक बता दिया
तो नहीं, अभी बताया था ना आपको वो डीएस वाला प्रॉब्लम. तो दिस इज ऑफ द फॉर्म सी एफ ऑफ आर डीएस ऐसा दे रखा है. तो इसको डीएस को क्या करना पड़ेगा आपको, एफ ऑफ आर डीएस बाय डीटी. ओके बट दिस डीएस बाय डीटी व्हाट टू डू, this is equal to the magnitude of r bar with respect to t, derivative of r bar with respect to t. ठीक है, यानी जो r bar दे रखा है, ये r bar दे रखा है आपका, ये problem अभी आपको बताया था ना शुरू शुरू में ही. yes y is equal to 3x, so derivative of r bar निकालो, then magnitude of derivative of r bar with respect to t निकालो. So this substitution will go here. What is f of r? That is given to b. So I'll come to it. So t ke limits is equal to whatever integration it is c under root of 2 plus square 3y square ds de rakha hai. Okay. So what I do is t limits I'll put it. T is bounded between 0 to 3 de rakha hai under root of 2. X is what? T. See the parametric representation given here, x is what? T, t square ho gaya, 3y square, but y is again t here. Okay, fine. So this will be plus t square, but see this is ye ds by dt iska ho gaya magnitude of derivative of r bar with respect to t, wo value substitute karo and then dt. Okay, what is this? 1 1 2 t. So this will be under root of 1 plus 1 plus 4 t square. So this is equal to under root of 2 plus 2 t 4 t square. Substitute under root of 2 plus 4 t square, and this under root will give you 2 plus 4 t square. छोड़ लीजिए, सिंप्लीफाई करो. क्या करना है, ये सिर्फ डीएस का ये फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट होना जरूरी है. जब तक आप नहीं करोगे फाइन है. और कुछ
मैम? और वो
नाउ सी दिस कर्व, सी दिस पाथ, स्ट्रेट लाइन फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट. यहाँ पे कौन से दो इक्वल है? जेड इक्वल है बट टू and one x alag hai, ye alag hai. So equation of this will be what? From this point to this point, what will be the equation of the straight line? You need to find out. Are you getting what I want to say?
Yes ma'am. X minus x1 upon x2 minus x1 equal to wo equal to lambda.
Yes, yes. And equal to t le lo, to aapko parametric representation iska mil jayega. Ya to fir aap aisa likh sakte ho, yes, that's the correct way. ये इसको parametric representation ही कर डालो. That is x minus x1 upon x2 minus x1 is equal to y का करो, z का करो, or is equal to t. So this will give you x is equal to some function in t, y function in t, z. The parametric representation. फिर dx is equal to, फिर dy is यहाँ पे y मिलता है. So dy is equal to and all that. And t की limits ढूंढो. So x is bounded between here, this will give you x bounded between 1 to 2. X is what? C there. Substitute, you'll get the limits for t. Are you getting what I want to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Fine. So you work it out. If you do not get, then you can ask. Anything else?
मैम अभी इसके पहले आप क्वेश्चन बोल रहे थे मैम, एज क्वेश्चन यू आर टॉकिंग समथिंग.
यस व्हिच क्वेश्चन
मैम? आप कोई तो भी एज क्वेश्चन बोल रहे थे ना
एज पार्ट. हां तो आपने कोशिश किया नहीं है क्या? बोलिए सर. दिस इज योर एज पार्ट, क्वेश्चन नंबर 23. ओके तो इसका कैसे करने वाले हो? दिस इज योर डबल इंटीग्रल x square plus y square whole square minus z square whole of ds. This is what they have given. Ds हो या ds, surface represent किया इसलिए वो ds बोल रहा है. Or else da, no problem with that. What to do with this? Yes. So
आपको ये बताना है.
This is
k dt
symbol. हाँ, आपको बताया है ना इसके लिए. This da is magnitude of n bar of du dv. Yes, here. और ये x का value substitute करो, y का value substitute करो, z का value substitute करो. And simplify this. Find this is n bar. Get the magnitude of n bar. Yes, here. And n bar du dv यहाँ पे da की जगह substitute. And u और v के तो limits दे रखी है. So this is done. Are you getting?
Ma'am, question number 21.
21 तो आपका वो तो Stokes theorem का है. Don't do that.
Ma'am, but like अच्छा ठीक है, ओके. मैम 21 और 22 स्टोक्स थ्योरम है क्या?
वो स्टोक्स का है प्रॉब्लम.
ओके
21 22 दैट इज स्टोक्स एग्जांपल, सो डोंट वर्क विद दैट. फाइन मैम.
ओके मैम.
ये जो के पार्ट है वो भी स्टोक्स में चला जाता है. डोंट डू दिस. ये f बार डॉट n कैप यहां पे दिख रहा है ना, ये वाला आप कर सकते हैं. ओके
मैम, 23 का 23 का i वाला पार्ट
ये उस दिन आपको बताया था ना, dy dz क्या होगा. यस, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस h पार्ट?
यस मैम.
ओके, ये सब uv में कन्वर्ट करना है. da इन पैरामेट्रिक फॉर्म इज व्हाट? मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ n बार नॉर्मल वेक्टर. यस या इन u एंड v du dv. Fine, yeah? The next is ith part. Ith part is what? Double integral cos y dy dz plus sin x dx dz plus cos z dx dy. ये ऐसा दे रखा है. इसमें से हमको this is f1 first component of f bar, second component and third component. F bar मिल गया हमको. Fine, yeah. You cannot, you, if you work with this, this becomes very hazardous. F1 is cos y sin x and F3 is cos z. ये आपको components F bar के दे रखे हैं. Surface S क्या दे रखा है? It's a closed surface of the cylinder x square. Closed बोल रहा है वो. Okay, x square plus y square is equal to 9 and z bounded between 0 to 2. He's saying closed surface, this. Okay, closed surface of the cylinder, this and this. So what can you say? Yes, can you tell me what you have to do?
Parametric.
Ma'am, I was doing R u comma v will be 3 cos u comma 3 sin u comma v for the cylinder.
Correct. 3 cos u, 3 sin 3 sin u, and z is equal to v. Correct it is. So v ki limits aapko seedhi milengi. Ab ye to aapka ye aisa cylinder hai, full cylinder hai, height going along z axis. Z is 0 here, z is equal to 2 here. Okay, so u is this 0 to 2 pi base angle, v, z is v. So v is bounded between 0 to 2, seedha seedha mil gaya. Are you getting? और 0 to 2 pi means you should immediately think.
Yes, ma'am.
कुछ functions के integral values they may become 0 या 4 times हो सकता है. तो 4 times हो गया तो 0 to pi by 2 हो जाएगा. 0 to pi by 2 means reduction apply होगा. That is how you will go about. Try for this example the same way. Yes,
so ma'am, then after we take r, so then we will substitute values of x, y, z in the equation directly, right? Like value of y, dy, dz and etc.
Why? What is it? What do you say?
Like we found r, right? 3 cos u comma 3 sin u comma v. So
r bar. After parameter.
Yes. So that is 3 cos u comma 3 sin u sin u and comma v.
Comma v. Okay.
So from here we know what x, y, and z are, right?
Substitute and see.
So we will direct. Okay, so we will directly substitute this in the equation, right, to solve it.
अरे नहीं सर, अरे बाप रे, अभी तो पूरी रामायण खत्म हो गई यार, स्टिल आप वहीं पे अटके हुए हो. डबल इंटीग्रल एफ बार डॉट एन बार, बिकॉज दिस इज द कर्व सरफेस, यू आर वर्किंग ओवर दिस सरफेस, नो, एफ बार डॉट एन बार. फाइन, एफ बार क्या है, ये है, तो वाई वाई थ्री साइन यू हो जाएगा यहाँ पे, कॉस ऑफ थ्री साइन यू, साइन एक्स, साइन ऑफ थ्री कॉस यू, cos z, so this will be cos v. Fine, ये f bar ये हो जाएगा. But prior to that, you need to ये r bar के बाद immediately the first question that arises is after r bar, next step is n bar because this is curved surface.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Got it. Got it. So the function was cos y comma sin x comma cos z. So from there we'll find f and n.
Yes, Yashwardhan.
Yes, ma'am. Got it. Like the function was cos y comma sin x comma cos z, and we know r, so then we find normal and then dot product.
That's the technique to find the surface that is normal vector, and
yes,
then
ma'am.
F bar, then dot product. That surface is double integral. All that you will begin with. Okay. Now you can
yes,
see
ma'am.
You have taken. So this is I J K. Okay. Partial derivative r bar with respect to u is minus 3 sin u, 3 cos u,
zero.
And 0. So this is 0, 0, 1. So you can see the first two components. So this is 0, 0, and third component is what? No. First component, what do you get? So what is your, no, this is 3 cos u. Second component is what? 0. Third component is what? 0. This is what you get. Find your n bar is equal to this. And find f bar in parametric form. F bar ye hai, x, y, z ki values dalo yahan pe. And then go for the dot product. Three limits are there with you. U is 0 to 2 pi.
And 0 to 2.
What karo?
Yes, ma'am. Got it.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Here, there's an equality sign here. So, over this surface only, you are supposed to work. Okay. Check it. Do you get 9 pi of cos 2 minus 1 or no? Okay. Any
yes,
other
ma'am.
Doubt? Fine. ये दोनों क्वेश्चन से
मैम हेलो
हाँ बोलिए सर
मैम विच कम ट्यूटोरियल हैज मोर वेटेज कम टी टू पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू
आई डोंट नो नॉट टेल यू आल्सो यस
ओके मैम नो प्रॉब्लम
एंड यू शुड नॉट आस्क आल्सो So we stop with it. If you have still the doubts with the problems, you post the solution, what you get, how you have worked out, let me see. And I'll check it and then you can repost. Okay. So we stop with this.